To set up a VPN server, you will need a public IP address. If you don't know if you have a public IP address, the instructions to check are listed in the description. If you don't have a public IP address, you can ask your internet service provider to assign you a public IP. The first step is to configure the VPN server. In this example, we will be using Brume 2 to host the VPN server. Enter Brume 2's web admin panel by going to your browser and entering 192.168.8.1. Click on the VPN tab. You can choose between OpenVPN and WireGuard. In this case, we will be using the WireGuard protocol to host our server as it is faster. Here we can use a random listen port. The maximum value is 65535. Click on Apply to start the server. The second step is called port forwarding. Port forwarding is only necessary if your data from the VPN server passes through additional devices before accessing the public internet. In such a case, we need to port forward data from devices in the upstream layer. In our case, Slate AX towards our VPN server. So now we enter the admin panel of Slate AX. Go to Firewall and under Port Forwarding, click on Add. Make sure you enter the same external port as your VPN server. For the internal IP address, you can check by going to Brume 2's admin panel and click on Internet. Go back to the admin panel of your VPN server. Click on VPN. Find your server and click on Profile. Here you will find your VPN configuration file. It is also available in QR code if you want to connect using your phone. The final step is to connect your client devices to your VPN server. If you are using a phone, download the WireGuard app. Click on Add a Tunnel and scan the QR code to connect. If you are using a computer, download the WireGuard app, export the VPN configuration file, and import it to the WireGuard app to connect. Make sure your tunnel file name is valid and does not have any spaces or special characters. If you want to connect your GLiNet router, go to your router's admin panel. Click on VPN, VPN client. Click on New Provider and upload the configuration files. After that, go back to the VPN dashboard and enable the VPN. If you wish to test if your VPN server works, make sure the tested client device like phones, computers, or travel routers are separated from your VPN server's local network. If your client devices have successfully connected to your VPN server, you should see data usage under your VPN dashboard.